Hey everybody, it's a brand new week, and this is May 21st, 2018, and this is Newsbreak. I'm Alex Bennett. Not much happened during the weekend, but we'll catch you up with it anyway. President Trump demanded Sunday that the Department of Justice investigate whether the FBI spied on its 2016 presidential campaign for political purposes. More obstruction of the Mueller case. More putting into doubt whether the president is being justly accused. We'll wait and see. But he just, it's one thing after another with this guy. It's just constant drama. I would like one day without hearing the name Trump. By the way, speaking of that first lady, Melania Trump left the hospital Sunday after being treated for a benign kidney condition for 5 days. I had kidney stones and I was only in for 4.5. Special counsel Robert Mueller is investigating a meeting between Donald Trump Jr. and not the Russians this time, an emissary for two Arab princes and an Israeli social media specialist before the 2016 election. Remember Cambridge Analytica? Well, they're the British firm that obtained user data from Facebook and worked on President Donald Trump's 2016 electoral campaign. They filed for bankruptcy. There is a God! Trade war between the United States and China has been put on hold, according to Treasury Secretary Steven Mnuchin, who said the trade tensions have been put aside as Chinese and American negotiators work to establish a framework that will allow both countries to address future trade imbalances. They don't mention that they're also waiting for the check to clear for the $500,000 for that Indonesian resort and hotel and golf course that Donald Trump is putting into Indonesia. But that's another story altogether, isn't it? That should be investigated. Well, over the weekend, I suppose you heard that Prince Harry and Meghan Markle tied the knot in a very small, insignificant wedding at Windsor Castle. Boy, did you see that thing. Well, the bill for the whole thing came to about $42.8 million. But the majority of that money wasn't paying for canapes. It was going towards keeping the betrothed and their guests safe and the onlookers as well. The cost of security, including snipers, undercover police, and counter UAV systems, was about $40.1 million, or 94% of the total wedding budget. In news this weekend, when it comes to entertainment, the number one movie in North America was Deadpool, having earned $125 million in receipts this weekend. My quick review, because we went to see it yesterday, is it's fun, it's good, it's not as fun as the first one, but you'll get your money's worth. And in the world of toys, Hasbro has announced that it's trademarked one of its most recognizable aspects of one of its most recognizable products. The product? Play-Doh. What are they trademarking? The smell of Play-Doh. I guess they should. Let's take a look at our picture of the day. This one comes from Auckland, New Zealand, where people were left scratching their heads in the afternoon as a light plane flew above Ericsson Stadium, towing a straight-talking banner. Let's look at that banner. If you look very closely, it's in the upper right-hand part of your picture, and it says, Scott Kelly has a small dick. Isn't that lovely? And in our video for today from the show, Friday nights, I and my betrothed get together and talk about various things. And this time we were talking about the fact that I had finally taken to going to the gym and working out. You got 2 minutes.
Well, it's going to take two minutes to get
2 minutes.
Oh, God. Oh.
Here we go. What? I showered today. I've been showering every day now.
Well, now that you're going to the gym.
We go to the gym, and then I come back, I'm all sweaty, and I have to...
Oh, you shower before you go to the gym?
No, I don't shower before I go to the gym. I shower after I get back from the gym.
You got the towel around your neck and... Rocky?
Well, I need to take the towel with me because otherwise I'd have to buy another $5 towel. And for a $15 gym, I don't want to up the ante too much, you know. And so that's what happened on our program on Friday night. We are here every night, Tuesday through Friday. And we're here at the hour of 10 o'clock until midnight. Okay. Gee, I can't even remember when I'm on anymore. If you want to watch it, go to youtube.com/BoloBennett/live. If you do that on your browser, you'll find a player with a countdown. Why don't you just like tab that in your browser and it'll be there all the time. When the show starts, that player starts playing the show. So you don't have to do a damn thing. Also, you can find us, as you know, on Facebook after the fact, YouTube. You can find us on Vimeo. You can find us on iTunes. You can find us on Livestream. You can find us on other places, too. Just go to our Gabnet.net page, and you'll be able to find out, because we're around town more, as I say, than a cheap suit. I'm Alex Bennett. That's it for today for Newsbreak. We'll see you again tomorrow. Thank you for joining me.